Hi, Travis from POSGuys.com. Today's question comes from Blake Marks. He was basically asking about the Epson U220B and asking if we can show some footage of it working and kind of go into an explanation of why we like thermal printers just more than impact printers. Blake, I'd be happy to answer that question and kind of show you some footage of it. Here I have a restaurant set up, the Epson U220B. I have it set up to print the receipt, and the Epson 88V. I have it set up to print the kitchen ticket. This is kind of the opposite of how most people set it up, but for this example, I just wanted to set it up that way. So I'm gonna print them both, and I'm gonna send this order through, and it's gonna print both the receipt and the kitchen ticket at the same time. So add some stuff to the order, and I am gonna finish up. Okay, so the first thing that comes obvious is that the thermal printer prints much faster and much quieter than the impact printer. However, the thing that the impact printer does that the thermal printer can't do is that it prints in two colors. So that's a major advantage for kitchen printing, because if you want things like no mail, or the temperature of the steak to really stand out, then if your software has the capability to highlight it in a different color, then it will, and that'll really make it stand out. So that's a very important thing when it comes to kitchen, because one of the worst things that can happen in a kitchen is to have to cook things twice. That really jams everything up and slows it down. So that is one of the main reasons you will see impact printers used as kitchen printers rather than thermal printers. The thermal printers work better, conversely, than the impact printers in the front of the house, because it's much quieter and it's also much faster, so you can print out all the receipts really quickly. It also has a higher print resolution, which means print quality when it comes down to it. One thing to keep in mind, though, when it comes to kitchen printing, is that heat is what's used to use the receipts. So if you have something hot like a stove, a pan, warming lights, and your kitchen tickets are exposed to it, they turn black. So if that's happening, that would be pretty much impossible for a kitchen to use. But with an impact printer, heat is just not going to be a factor. So for kitchen printing, this is definitely the way to go over that. For receipt printing, thermal is the way to go for that. One other thing to look at is if you are going to be doing graphics on your receipt or barcodes on your receipt, then thermal printers are just superior. For instance, I will print a receipt, and we're going to start with a thermal printer. So I'll print the receipt on the thermal printer. It printed nice and fast. You can see the logo is at the top of the receipt. Now let me switch to the impact printer. And I will finish an order up. And I'll print that same receipt with the impact printer. So a very similar receipt. The styling for the impact's a little different, but the logo's at the top, and you can see how much slower it printed the graphics. Graphics on an impact printer, barcodes on an impact printer print at a lower quality and slower. So really, it's not recommended if you're gonna be doing that. If you're going to be just printing a basic receipt without any kind of logo, it prints okay speed-wise, but it is loud. So if your store is outdoors or it's like a hardware center, and it doesn't matter, you can have a loud receipt, no one cares, then impact printers can work fine. Overall though, thermals, kind of what we recommend for all kind of receipts. There are low cost thermal printers that are the same price or cheaper than impact printers now. So really you can find a good thermal printer for a low price. So that's why we push it. As far as supplies go, basic bond paper is cheaper than thermal printer, so that is a money saver there. However, you do have to buy ribbon, so keep that in mind. The ribbon does last for quite a long time. There are different types of ribbon, different colors. There's the black red for doing dual color thermal or dual color printing, or there's solid black, or there's solid purple on it. But you do have to have ribbon, so keep that in mind that you're buying paper and ribbon versus buying just thermal paper that won't use any kind of ribbon. Hopefully, Blake, that answers your questions. We'll also do a follow-up video where we're going to do an in-depth review on the U220B, and we'll link it to this video as well. For more information on the printer or supplies, please visit us at POSGuys.com. Thanks.